Brian is with us. Brian's in Winston-Salem. Hey, Brian, how are you?
Hi, I'm all right. How are you doing, sir?
Better than I deserve. What's up?
Well, actually, my question is more for my daughter. I run a martial arts school in the off of Winston, or a little out of south side of Winston, and I am honestly not done the best of jobs. I started listening to your podcast.
Your phone is kind of breaking up and going sideways on me. Can you stand in a different place or something, or talk directly into it?
Yes, sir. Let me stand elsewhere.
There
is that
go.
Better, sir?
Yes, sir. Thank you. Sorry about that. So you got a martial arts school, and you said you've not done the best of job. What do you mean?
I have not run it very well. I've run it more like a hobby, to be honest with you. My daughter's getting a little older. She's now 16, about to be a junior in high school. And she tells me that's what she wants to do for a living. As I look around, I realize I've really kind of failed, not having good systems and everything else. So my goal is I want her to be set up to do better than I have. And we've already, last year she went through the personal finance or foundations of personal finance for high school. She's homeschooled. And then this year she's going to be going through the foundations in entrepreneurship from you guys as well. And I'm just trying to figure out the best ways to deal with this. We actually print our own shirts for our school. So I thought about setting that up as a business and kind of either having her run it or manage it or something, so she gets a better foundation in actually how to do this and kind of make that a part of her school curriculum this upcoming year.
Well, that doesn't hurt anything, but that doesn't train her to run a martial arts studio. I mean, that's a teenage side job where we do t-shirts. But then running a business is a teenage representation of running a business. And that's not a bad thing. It's always good to teach kids how to be entrepreneurs. I love that. But if you're actually wanting to have her come in and take over the store at some point, you've got to get the store running right.
Yeah.
And then she'll find her own mistakes to make later, but she doesn't need to make yours.
Well, that's what I'm trying to avoid at the moment. I want her to be able to come up, because she tells me that's what she wants to do.
Yeah.
She wants to be an entrepreneur.
Yeah.
And I feel like I've been a bad example of that. So I'm trying to set her up the best way possible.
Well, what I would do, it's fine to do the t-shirt thing. That's not a bad thing. But in addition to that, what I would do is you sit down and say, okay, here's the areas to yourself, you and your wife, or you just sit down at the kitchen table. Here's the areas I'm deficit in. Here's what I'm missing. I don't have systems. I'm not good at marketing. Our accounting is bad. Here's whatever it is that you're struggling with, because you have some things in your mind that you think you're not good at. Am I right?
Right. Correct.
And so then we got to go get those skills. So you jump in like Entree Leadership Elite, or you get an Entree coach, or you start reading some books, or whatever you do, but you start acquiring those skills to implement into the business. As you're doing that, let's just do a real world example. Okay, what is the area of the business that is the absolute worst in your mind? What category?
Probably just the systems of actually running the business itself. I've always kind of haphazardly done things.
Give me an example, because I don't know what you mean when you say that.
Bookkeeping.
Okay.
Kind of managing. That would probably be one.
So your accounting system is horrendous.
Correct.
Okay. That's a good example. That's not unusual, by the way, for a company your size. So it's one of the things that most small businesses struggle with. So what I would do is sit down with her, regardless of whether we're doing the t-shirt thing or not, and say, listen, I know you want to be an entrepreneur someday, and I'm kind of scared that I've not set a good example. So I'm going to start setting a better example today. And here's the first thing I'm doing. The first thing I've identified, honey, is the weakest part of our studio is the accounting systems. And I know that, and I've tolerated it, and starting today, I'm not going to tolerate it anymore. So you get to walk beside me and watch me go through the discovery process of how I'm going to put a new accounting system in that actually works, how I find that accounting system by talking to someone who has a very successful studio in another city similar size, and you say, what do you use? And you talk to different software companies, and you look at the stuff, and you try to find something that works, and then she gets to watch you discover it, find it, and then implement it, and go through the pain and the frustration of learning something new and throwing out old broken crap and putting in a new shiny thing. And it takes longer than you thought it was going to, and it's really hard. But she gets to watch you do all of that. Guess what? That is an entrepreneur.
Yeah.
That is that's an adult that throws her shoulder back and runs straight into the storm and fixes crap. That's an entrepreneur. That's entrepreneur training. She watches her dad fix stuff he wasn't good at and admitted, and watches this business flourish as a result. And then what's the next one? We're not good at social media. Okay, we're going to freaking learn how to, you know, put this stuff out on TikTok. And, you know, we're going to get some people in here that can teach us this, and they're 14 years old, but we're going to get them in here. And, you know, whatever it is, on to the next thing and on to the next thing. So Brian, I started doing that here 17 years ago. We reached a point in our growth that we had areas of the business that were running extremely well. Okay, God, what is my job now at Ramsey? Yeah, I know it's not to just be on the stage or on the microphone. I know I also have an operational job. What do you want me to do, God? And it was really clear in my mind. It's almost like he yelled at me. He said, fix broken things and work on new things. And that's been my job for 17 years as the CEO of this place. I work on the broken things and the new things. And so I'll step into an area that's bad and struggling and do just exactly what I just told you to do. I get in discovery mode. I don't know squat about it, but I got to figure it out. So right now at this moment, I'm sitting in meetings with these digital geniuses that I have in the building, and they speak another language. I don't even know what they're saying. 3 hours ago, I just said, you know, you're really way smart, but you're not smart enough to explain what you do where I can understand it. So try again. Because I'm like in charge and stuff, so you got to teach me what the crap you're saying so we can work on this together. That was a discussion I had 3 hours ago in this building, because I'm working on broken stuff. We got a digital thing that's up a creek without a paddle, to say the least. It's driving me bananas, and we're going to freaking fix it, you know? And guess what? Guess who's watching me do that? My son, who's the president of the company, Daniel Ramsey, sitting in the dadgum meeting with me going, calm down, Dave. And I'm like, I ain't calming down. This crap's broken, you know?
Yeah.
And this is exact conversation. So he's been mentored watching dad for 17 years work on new things and broken things. And that's the best training I could give him on running a business, because that's what a real entrepreneur does. We don't tolerate substandard crap in our presence ongoing. We got to fix it. And it's really intimidating, and it's really scary, and it's really frustrating, because I feel dumb half the time doing it, because I am the dumbest person in the room, usually on the thing I'm working on, because everybody else understands what the flip it is, except they ain't fixed it. So still, we got to work on it together. That's the whole thing. And so I just get to be the driving force, the boot up the butt that keeps things moving. And you get to, what your daughter gets to watch you do that. You're teaching her how to be an entrepreneur, dude. So go fix this business one element, one category at a time, and let her watch you. Let her sit on your shoulder while you do it. This is the Entree Leadership Podcast.